بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ومن اتبع هديه إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أحبتي في الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. My brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greeting of Islam, the greeting of أهل الجنة. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله ثم الحمد لله على نعمة الإيمان. The witness of Allah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us Jannah inshaAllah and relieve us from all this pain and fear that we live these days. As we are living today the 27 of Rajab, which is the journey of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Isra wal Miraj, the late journey, the night journey. We look at it and we see what lessons that we can take from it and implement it in our life right now and what we are facing these days. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the time of the al-Isra wal Miraj, they call this year the year of sadness. The sadness of losing his beloved Khadija radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, the one she supported him with her wisdom and her money. And his uncle, Abu Talib, the one who protect him from the imminent threat of Quraysh, they want to kill him. He lose both of them in this year. And this is what's called Aam al-Huzn, the year of sadness. And then he tried to find some protection in this earth from Ahl al-Ta'if. And he went to Ta'if to seek their protection against Quraysh, but they didn't give him the protection. They actually humiliate him and throw him out of the Ta'if. And with this, he returned and supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send him Malik al-Jibal, the angel of the mountain, and he told him, Ya Muhammad, if you give me the permission, I will destroy Ahl al-Ta'if by the two mountain and destroy them. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, no, because he is praying that from asladihim, from this generation, Allah will, you know, he supplicate to Allah that comes out in the future people that worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and don't have partner with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then from there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send him Jibreel and the ride, which is a buraq, and he reached Sidrat al-Muntaha, and where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give the command to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by the salah, as-salawat al-khams. And we all of us know the story that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala command Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the ummah of Muhammad 50 salah per day. And Musa, peace upon him, he told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, your ummah will be hard for them to follow the 50 prayer, and then he go back and forth to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking for mercy for the salah until it's written 5 prayers, and Allah will write it 50 prayer, give the reward for 50 prayer. Then when we look to the story of the Isra wal Miraj and look to our status in this dunya right now and what the whole ummah and the whole entire world with the globe facing right now, it's a test for our iman and our belief and what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is capable to do and who can get us out of this calamity and out of this challenge and what can we take from the lessons of the Isra wal Miraj. That if we face a calamity, if we lost a loved one, if we are facing fear, imminent threat, death facing us and we cannot know where it's come from, then we run to Allah. Firru ila Allah. Run to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through your salah, through your dua, through your supplication, through istighfar, through salah ala Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remove this ghumma and get us together again in the masajid of Allah. The masajid that we focus in building it, and now, subhanAllah, it's empty and vacant, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bring us back to this gathering in Ramadan or before Ramadan. and we learn the lessons that it's not the size of the masajid that matter, is the size of our heart, that we can fulfill it with the iman and the dua and helping our brothers and sisters in need. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us all and to learn from the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, how to follow his footstep and how to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and understand that he is the qadir ala kulli shay, and he is the one who can get us out of our misery. And without him, we will be in a status of loss. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to grant us Jannah inshaAllah and to save all mankind from this imminent threat. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه الغفور الرحيم والحمد لله رب العالمين.